You can see it looks completely different. You go on career as well. This is where you'll find like battle royale, stuff like that, and also there's new upcoming events, different challenges. Welcome back to another GeoGuessr video. In today's video, we're going to be looking at the completely new revamped GeoGuessr sites and everything, like the game in general, completely revamped, and we're going to take a look at this new update which only came out a couple of days ago. So yeah, leave a like on the video if you enjoy, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. That'll be very appreciated. I might sound a little bit off this video because I do have a very sore throat, like it's quite bad. Sometimes it's uncomfortable to gulp and swallow, so yeah, it's not great. So I might sound a little bit more off this video, but I need to bring you out this video because we need to look at the new, how it looks now. So as you can see, it looks completely different. You go on career as well. This is where you'll find like battle royale, stuff like that. And also there's new upcoming events, different challenges. So it's like, so for example, you can play battle royale distance, but with different difficulty and stuff like that. It's like battle royale, but like with different tweaks to it to make it more challenging, which is quite cool. I like that. There's a new ranked system as well, as you can see here. But yeah, let me know in the comments what you think of the whole new design. I reckon when they brought out City Streaks, they had an idea that they're going to revamp it, because it's kind of a bit similar to how they done City Streaks, the design of that. So, but I do like it. It's a bit difficult to get used to. Like, it's different, very different. But I think all in all, I think it'll be look. I think it'll look better in the long run, because they're trying to make it more like an actual game rather than a website, which is what they're trying to aim at. So, but yeah, as I say, I haven't planned this video, by the way. So, but yeah, so you can see all the game modes here. There's some career, like a career mode type thing. If you play with friends as well, you can set up challenges, and then the classic is kind of similar, but they've just changed the font and stuff, and they've, but this is very similar. The classic mode, classic GeoGuessr. This is where I'll still be doing the play-alongs and stuff like that. But yeah, you see the fonts change. Let me know what you think. I do like it, however, as I said, it is different, and it will take a bit of getting used to. So let's go on one of these little coming events. Country Slowpoke. Let's try this. I'll show this one. Relax, let's pull the map, but yeah. Okay, so this is okay. So I say this is more like a slower paced version, which would be quite cool actually. I think sometimes as good country battle royale can be, you do it can be a bit too fast paced at times, especially when you know the country, but other people are just fast. So yeah, as I said, this one's a bit more relaxed, a bit more slower paced. This should be Bulgaria though. I don't think I'll take too long on this. The winter coverage, the oval field, the look about it, it's very Bulgaria. Could be Hungary, but no, it is Bulgaria. Let me know what you think of this like design as well. Or you prefer the old one. Like how it came up with like a green thing on the screen, so correcting big bold text, but this one is a bit more subtle, but I kind of like it. But yeah, as you say, it's got more of that City Streaks feel to it, the competitive City Streaks. It's got that more of that like purple vibe, the purple colour and the font and everything. I do like it, it's just, it is different. Alright, next round. Is this like Singapore or something? Yeah, I think it is. Singapore's got like such a distinct vibe to it. Could be Malaysia actually, but no, it is Singapore. Yeah, Singapore's got such a like, distinct vibe to it. I didn't have to move. I just had a feeling it was Singapore there. This should be New Zealand. It's meant to be like a slower paced. I think like the time is not as quick, but yeah, we still battering through these. Oh, nice. Okay, we got that first. There's a story to Australia first, but yeah, we're in the final already. That was a quick game. A lot of people got knocked out on that first one, which is surprising. I don't really know on this one. This is not as obvious. I'm gonna like, it's Poland here. No, it might be Hungary. No, I'm not a botched this up. He's using 50-50. Oh, he's Croatia. Okay, I was in the right sort of area. I knew it was Eastern Europe. I used his 50-50 though. I didn't have time to click on my 50-50 and use it. So, but yeah, very quick game there. Okay, so I assume this one's quicker. I think the timer goes well quicker on this, especially later on in the rounds. Is this, what's this? Not really getting into now. Okay. Not a Croatia. No. Is this Baltic for any chance? I'm trying to read that language. Nah. Looks like looks Latvian or Lithuania, isn't it? Let's keep looking though, there's no need to rush just yet. Could be like Czech Republic or something as well. No, I am going to actually go for Czech Republic here. Okay, it was Czech Republic, alright. Just gauging other guesses there as well. Because the language looked a bit Latvian and a bit Lithuanian, but yeah, Czech Republic also makes sense there, so. Got on then the end. But yeah, I'm pretty sure with his country flash, I'm pretty sure by each round, the timer goes quicker and quicker, I think. I'm pretty sure that's how it works anyway. Correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, we'll find it for ourselves anyway, while we? So I'm still a bit getting familiar with all these different modes and stuff like that, so. And all these events and stuff. Right, what's this? This is Gen 4, I think. I think this is Brazil. Might be Mexico as well. But I think it's Brazil. Yeah, thought so. Right, okay. I'm finally on the next round. I had to wait quite a bit there for the low round to finish, but we are finally here. So, yeah, this has got to be Norway for me. The row markings, the fact that I think this is Gen 4, I'm pretty sure. Probably Gen 3, can't quite tell. But yeah, it was Norway. We'll have a look. But yeah, the row is, I'll also give you a few tricks here. The row markings, yellow in the middle, but like the gaps in between. The overall feel of it as well. I can't really explain it. It just looks Scandinavian, I guess. It's not as mountainous though as other parts of Norway usually get, so. But yeah, after you play GeoGuessr for quite a bit, you just get vibes. You just know sometimes. Okay, next round. Let's have a look. What we got here? This looks. Ah, is that Polish bollard? I think it is. I think that's a Polish bollard. Hopefully. Maybe. Okay, it is. Okay, I'll second guess myself there. Sometimes you get like similar ones I've seen in France, but I'm pretty sure they're like, that they might be thicker or something. I'm not too sure, but yeah, that was Poland. Also, this pole here looks quite Polish, or like, it looked Lithuanian as well. You get like similar little poles in Lithuania. But yeah, we're going for this quite quickly, to be fair. Right in the last four. Okay, this is either Germany or Austria, I think. This has got to be Germany for me. We have like the washed up camera quality, looks very bright. We also have Gen 2 with a wide blur. Yeah, this is Germish for surely. Okay, Mr. Worldwide probably thought it was Austria. We were in the final three. This should be Sweden. It looks quite Scandinavian. We also have the short dash lines on the side. Just gonna hover over Norway just in case, or Finland, but no. Nope. We're in the final. This is, okay, this guy hasn't got his 50-50, so can't be using, he can't use that. I say that I sometimes use it, don't I? God, actually not sure here. Looks. No. I'm not too sure on these poles. Well, oh, okay. You know, I mean, not the greatest with poles, but this should be Hungary. And we won, nice. See, Utska there, that's, I think it means street or something like that in Hungarian. But yeah. Not bad. Right, so I'm actually going to go on Diverse World now, just to have a quick game on there, because they've kind of changed how it looks a bit on the on maps as well. So if you just go on Diverse World, as you said, they've completely changed this search bar as well. It comes up with a completely different tab sort of thing. But yeah, you'll know what Distance Battle Royale looks like. It's pretty much the same. Really the same as countries and stuff. So, but yeah, I'm going to show you how it looks on here. So you can see it looks different at the top. I like that. And that's quite cool. So we're going to quickly go for this. We're not going to like take our time with it or anything. We just have a quick squint and see what we can come up with. To be fair, I'm not actually 100% sure on this one. We are drawing on the... Oh god, I actually haven't got much of a clue here. Can you see the plates there? Right, we're not taking this game too serious anyway. We need to go through. I'm just gonna guess Turkey. It looks kind of Turkish. It was Russia, which also makes sense as well. Yeah, definitely in that region there. But yeah, I know no style. I couldn't see any Cyrillic writing or anything, so I didn't know it was for sure it was Russia. Just picked a country out of a few. Was on my mind. Okay, this should be France. Do we have a domain on here? Nope, but this is France or Belgium, but let's go for France and let's go like there. That was good. Yeah, near Paris, not too bad. As you see as well, the points are different at the bottom as well, which it's different, but yeah, I'm not sure what I like it, but it's just different, isn't it? It's very different. Okay, we have a sign down there. This is Denmark, very Danish sign. We'll just go like there. Nice, cool. This one is all these ballads. Don't think it's Czech Republic or Slovakia or Poland. It's not Poland about that. It's probably I think this is Lithuania. Or definitely Baltic in that region. Let's go like there. Lithuania it was. And the last round. Let's go for, I don't know, let's see, what's this plate? Oh, we have a red tint. We have a red tint. Does that mean this is Belgium? It could be. This has got the Belgium. Yeah, like a red tint on the number plates. It's got it there. Continue. Okay. Oh, it was just Russia. It was just Russia. I mean, fair enough. Didn't really give me such Belgian vibes. I just went off the plate, which kind of looked a bit red. But yeah, not to worry. Still had a decent game anyway. You can see the points and everything looks different here. Yeah, let me know what you think of that in the comments as well. Whether you think you like that, or do you think you prefer the old version, or the old look, the old design. 16 is 17k. I mean, I've rushed through that game, but got a few decent guesses in there. It's mainly just two rounds, wasn't it, that let us down. Both in Russia as well. Of course, Russia usually does let you down, GeoGuessr. But yeah, hopefully you did enjoy this video. And looking at the new update, let me know what you think of the new GeoGuessr update in the comments below. Hopefully my throat clears up and it's better again soon, because it's quite bad at the moment. But yeah, let me know what you think of the new update. And next video, I might do another Sport Club video actually. I haven't done one of those in a little while, so I might do a quiz on there. I might revisit me naming as many countries as I can in 15 minutes. See if I can do better than last time. That'll be quite cool if I can beat my record from last time. But also, yeah, I will do another play along, a GeoGuessr play along again very soon as well. So, got a few videos I want to do in mind. So, yeah, stay tuned and I'll see you very soon.